This video lecture explains the definition of the first order linear dynamic system. Any system for which the behavior of the system can be represented by the first order linear differential equation, we say the system is first order linear dynamic system. The standard format of the linear dynamic equation is this. In this equation, r of t is the input, y of t is the output. The parameters a and b are constant. This means they don't change with time. This is why the equation is time invariant. We say it is first order differential equation because the highest derivative in the equation has first order, as you see in dyt upon dt. The block diagram representation of a system can be given by this figure. In this figure, the system can be any electrical system or mechanical system or an economic system. We excite the system by a signal r of t and it gives us y of t. If this response y of t behaves like the y of t in equation number 1, we say that the system is first order linear dynamic system. From the linear we mean, suppose that if the input to the system is r of t, output is y of t. Now if we say a r1t is the input and the output is a1t, and for the input b r2t, the output is b y2t, then according to the superposition theorem, the system will be linear system if a r1t plus b r2t input to the system give us an output a y1t plus b y2t. Any system which obeys the principle of the superposition, we say it is the linear system. If the dynamics of a linear system can be represented by the first order differential equation of the format 1, we say it is first order linear dynamic system. Let us explain this concept with the help of an example from the electrical circuits. In this circuit, the input to the system is VIT and output is the voltage across the capacitor. We say it is VCT. Assume the capacitance value is C and the resistor value is R and both of them are constant. This means the value of R and C do not change with time. Now, if we close the switch S, a current I of t will flow through the circuit. The current through the resistor R and capacitor C will be same as these two electrical components are connected in the series. From the basic definition of the capacitor, we know that the charge across the capacitor is proportional to the voltage across the capacitor. This is why Q of t will be equal to C Vc t. Then it is easy to say that I of t, which is the rate of flow of the charge in the circuit, is given by the relationship dqt upon dt is equal to C dvct upon dt. Here it is important to note that the voltage across the resistor will be equal to R I of t, and here inserting the value of I of t, we can get RC dVCT upon dt. This is the voltage across the resistor. Now it is easy to write the sum of the voltages across the components in this circuit, R C dVCT upon dt is the voltage across the resistor R plus VCT is the voltage across the capacitor C will be equal to VIT. Equation 1 is originally written on the basis of the Kirchhoff's voltage law. This equation we may rewrite in this format. If we compare this equation with the standard equation written on the previous slide, we find that V of IT is the input to the system and VCT is the output of the system, and the variables parameters A is equal to B is equal to 1 over RC. Here it is important to note that capacitor is an electrical component which stores the energy. This means it is an capacitor is a memory element. This means it can retain the information of the signal. So any system which has a memory element, that can be represented by dynamic systems. And the dynamic systems characteristics are replicated by the differential equation. If the memory elements are linear and the other components in a circuit are also linear, then such circuits can be represented by the first order differential equation if there is only one memory element. If there is more than one memory element, there is a possibility of getting higher order differential equation. Now consider the example from mechanical systems. In this system, this symbol represents the damper. In the damper, the force is directly proportional to the velocity, where this block represents the mass M. The force across the damper will be F of V into V of T, where V of T is the velocity and F of V is the coefficient of the friction in the damper. So using the Newton law, we can write that M dvt upon dt. Here dvt upon dt represents the acceleration. This means it is ma plus fv into v of t is the force across the damper will be equal to the applied force f of t. This equation can be rewritten in the following format: dvt upon dt plus fv upon mass m and the velocity v of t is equal to f of t divided by m. If we compare this equation with the fundamental equation of the linear differential, first order linear differential equation, dyt upon dt plus a y of t is equal to b r of t. This means input to the system is f of t, output of the system is the velocity v of t. The parameter a is equal to fv upon m and the parameter b is equal to 1 over m. So these are the two examples from electrical and mechanical engineering. One can find similar examples in chemical engineering, in civil engineering, and in other disciplines in the natural sciences and social sciences. Thank you very much for listening to the lecture.